Hello, just another little behind the scenes on Survivor China. One of the key jobs on our show is that of a dream teamer. A dream teamer is usually somebody in their early 20s. Each season we hire about 16 to 20 people, and without them we couldn't do the show. But rather than me tell you what a dream teamer is, I'm gonna let the dream teamers tell you themselves. Alex, you're a dream teamer. Give me the lowdown. What does a dream teamer do?
A dream teamer is a crash test dummy. We essentially test and practice all the challenges before the survivors do them. So we basically suss everything out before the shoot day comes so everything runs smoothly.
Cool, thanks.
Thank
Alex
you.
Is also the producer of these behind the scene videos. You're doing a good job. Will, first season Dream Teamer, how are you enjoying it?
I'm enjoying it. It's fun. You get to test so many different challenges, and the only thing, the difference between the survivors and us is that we get to eat and they don't.
Lance, one of the best stories ever of somebody who became a Dream Teamer. Give it to us.
Well, I was sitting at home watching Survivor from Canada, can't be on the show, so I thought the next best thing would try to be on the Dream Team. Had some friends kind of challenged me that I couldn't do it. I wrote a letter to a former contestant telling her how much I liked the show, how much I liked the travel, and pushed myself. She forwarded on to John. John called me up, and 2 days later he said he's going to take a risk on me, and next thing I know I'm in China doing challenges for the summer.
That is a crazy story. Are you glad that you did it? Has it lived up to your expectations?
Oh yeah, man. It's so hard to explain, but it's been the time of my life. It's 2 months hanging out in China, competing, meeting great people, watching the show that I love develop, and yeah, it's a great time.
Whenever we rehearse a challenge, we treat the Dream Teamers just like we would survivors. We explain the challenge to them to see how they're going to run it, to try to anticipate what the survivors might do. John Kerhofer explains that challenge, stealing a lot of my language.
Disgusting, you're going to go and cruise through the mucky swamp water, okay? If you try to overthink it, you're going to get tied up in knots and lose. And today, for a bar card and 2 cases of beer, you don't want to lose. So, cruise through.
Beer is a big motivator for the Dream Team. That's the thing we use to get them to fight their best at challenges. When you're not testing challenges, what else are you doing?
Just getting into the other departments. Art is mainly where we spend our time. Painting and just building challenges. It's really great when someone asks you to do something and just try and figure something out to use your creativity.
And when the Dream Teamers aren't rehearsing challenges or working in art, they are hauling gear. Believe it or not, there's a person in front of that bag.
It's me!
Jenny, you are earning your money, girl. Dream Team is not only a good job in and of itself, but it also opens you up to other opportunities within the show. Edwin, I'm gonna interrupt you while you're working. Doing a story on Dream Teamers, including people on the show who started as Dream Teamers. I love that you're not stopping working. Give me your story. We picked you up in Panama, right?
Yeah, in Panama, let's say 4 years ago, 2003, season 8.
And you were a Dream Teamer, and you are now, what is your official title now?
Challenge Lead.
So you have worked into a full-time career here.
Yeah, pretty much. As soon as I finished school, I came up here and then start working with John and the guys, and honestly, it's the best job I've ever had. Is that a good English?
That is very good English.
Actually, I learned how to speak English with you.
I remember.
Yeah, yeah.
I remember those days. You've changed a lot, my friend.
Thank you.
Mike Matsumoto, former Dream Teamer, now integral part of our show. Tell us your story.
Well, I started out on Guatemala Dream Team. Good friends with John Kerhofer. He got me in. I was so excited. Loved the job. It was the best thing that ever happened to
but
me.
But you weren't going to be a Dream Teamer for long.
No. The very next season, I popped my head into Doug McCauley's office, and I guess I just made such good friends that he decided to shove me on Exile Island all by myself, 3 days, 2 nights at a time.
And being a segment producer.
Being a segment producer.
That's a big jump from Dream Team to segment producer.
It is a big jump and huge responsibility, and they took a lot of faith in me, and I love them for doing it.
Another thing the Dream Team does when they're not practicing challenges or working in other departments is at Tribal Council, they will sit in as though they were the survivor so that we can light. And that's because every time we come up here, we light it fresh. We never just walk up and use the old lighting. So you can see what's going on here tonight. They're all just sitting in as though they were survivors. Riley sitting in as though she were me. We'd probably do a much better job. Ninja, looking at all the lights, making sure everything's good. And so their work is never done. They work long hours from early in the morning until late at night, and we use them anywhere and everywhere. It is really, as I've been saying through this piece, one of the coolest jobs ever, and if I were in college and could get my application and photo to John Kirchhoffer, that's what I would do.
What'd you expect when you heard the phrase Dreamteamer, and how is it different?
You know what, I didn't really expect much from the phrase itself. I just knew it was gonna be like hard work and really, really fun. By the way, it's the most amazing experience I could have ever dreamed of. And then we get paid to play.
You got a bus to catch, man.
Yeah, I do.
Later, Rigo.
All right, no problem.
And that is what the Dream Team does every single day. Hope you've enjoyed a little behind the scenes of Survivor China.